Welcome to Hayat Torah. Be'ezrat Hashem, today we're going to start a new class on Shabbat, on Halachot Shabbat, and the importance of Shabbat, and many concepts that need to be clarified, and also we need to go back and review. As we know, one of the areas of Halacha, Jewish laws, one needs to constantly review is Halachot Shabbat. So Be'ezrat Hashem, today in this class we're going to review. So it is brought in Yahud Yosef, Chelek Revi'i, Halachot Shabbat, Harav Yitzchak Yosef, Shalita writes, that Nema B'Yishaya, it says in Yishaya, Sefer Yishaya, Perek Nun Chet, Pasuk Yud Gimel, V'Gharata L'Shamat Onek, that Shabbat is called Onek, whatever Onek means, if we can translate Onek to enjoyment, right? Shabbat is called Day of Enjoyment. Ve'amru be'gemara, and it is mentioned in Talmud, Gemara, Shabbat, Chuf Yud Chet Amud Bet, page 118, Amud Aleph. The first side, Amar Rav Yuchanan Mishom Rav Yosi, that Rav Yuchanan says in the name of Rav Yosi, Kol hamit'aneg et ha-Shabbat notenim lo nachala beli mesarim. Whoever enjoys Shabbat, he will get the portion to come, the portion in the world to come, without Yisurin, without difficulties. Shenemar, as he says, that Oz, referring to the world to come, one who observes Shabbat, he will rejoice getting the rewards in the world to come, enjoyment of the inheritance of Yaakov Avinu. Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak Amar, Rav Nachman the son of Yitzchak says, Nisul Mishibud Igaliot. One who keeps Shabbat, Hashem will save him from the difficulties of the Mashiach era, the time of Mashiach, the generation when Mashiach is coming. Perhaps in our times, that we see so many references and so many signs that Mashiach is coming. Okay, so yeah, Amar Rav Yehuda says in the name of Rav, Kol Hamid Na'eg Et HaShabbat Notenim Lo Mish'alot Libo, that whoever enjoys Shabbat, and really means whoever observes Shabbat, because through observing of Shabbat you truly enjoy Shabbat. Shabbat is not something physical, Shabbat is mostly spiritual, although some refer to Shabbat as a day of rest, right? And they sleep maybe, more than other times of the week, 10 hours straight, 12 hours some do. And that's not the true meaning of Shabbat observance. True meaning of Shabbat observance is when a person uses Shabbat to connect to Hashem through services, prayers, through learning Torah. That's the real oneg, through food, right? The meals that we have, seuda, rishona, shenia, shlishit. So, and even the Melave Malka, even the last seuda that we have after Shabbat, right? One is supposed to give a lot of importance to that seuda. That's Melave Malka, as the name indicates, that refers to, living, escorting out the Malka, escorting out the queen. Who is the queen? Is the queen Shabbat. Shabbat Malketa. So let's go on with this. So whoever keeps Shabbat, Hashem will bring his wishes come true. Lefikach, therefore, Sarich Adam lezarez et asmo. A person needs to be zariz. He needs to encourage himself. כדי לכבד השבת, in order to honor Shabbat, יש אומרים שמצוות עונג שבת היא רעה מן התורה, that those who say that the מצווה of עונג שבת, enjoyment and observing of the Shabbat, it's from Torah. The true enjoyment of Shabbat is from Torah. והשבת הוא בכלל מראי חודש. And Shabbat is called מראי חודש, it's a holy day. שנאמר, as it says in the Pasuk, וביום השביעי שבת שבתון מראי חודש. That on the seventh day, it's called Shabbat Shabbaton, the day of rest above all the days of rest. Right? Is the Shabbat Shabbaton, it's the ultimate Shabbat. ומראי חודש, פירושו חז"ל, המראי חודש are sages of blessed memory explain in Sifra. דהיינו לחדשו ולכבדו בכסות נקייה. That through wearing clean clothing, having a special clothing for Shabbat, that's how you sanctify Shabbat. That's how you make Shabbat different than other days of the week. ולענגו בעונג אכילה ושתייה, and one needs to enjoy the enjoyment of eating and drinking on Shabbat. Obviously, drinking doesn't mean alcohol beverages to the point of becoming drunk, chas v'shalom. One is not supposed to become drunk, and it's something davar megune. It's very bad. It's something that one needs to always stay away, because a person who is drunk, he cannot be true Oved Hashem. Yep. ולבניהם בעת שאוכלה צריך לכוון לקיים מצווה מן התורה. And when you have the seudot, when you partake in a meal of Shabbat, you should have in mind that you're performing, you're observing the mitzvah min haTorah, the mitzvah that is from Torah, commanding and observing of Shabbat. ויש חולקים ואומרים, and there are those who argue and they say, אף על פי שאין חיוב מצד ההלכה, even though that from halakha viewpoint, there is no mitzvah to have onek Shabbat, to enjoy Shabbat. Mikol makom mi sheyochal lichnot basar leShabbat. One who has the ability, who has the financial ability to buy meat for Shabbat, tov v'hagon sheyaseh ken. It is good and proper to do this. ויירבה בבשר ויין ובתבשילין כפי יכולתו. And one needs to increase the amount of meat and wine or other types of cooked food that he has based on his ability for the sake of Shabbat. ובכל מקום יענגוהו מאכלים ומשכים החשובים להם עונג. Now in every place one needs to follow the minhag, the custom of that place. If it's Los Angeles, you know, people have korma sabzi.
Ashesht, no.
What they have?
Choresht.
Choresht, right. They have tudeli, gondi, all sorts of, you know, delicacies to add to the simcha of Shabbat. ובכל מקום, ומי שאין בידו לנהוג בבשר, ומי שאין בידו לנהוג בבשר, ינהגו כפי יכולתו. Now if a person is not able to buy meat, right, Baruch Hashem, over here in United States, we are blessed with the abundance of meat at a good price. Mostly places are much less expensive than other locations in the whole world. So if one is able to buy, should buy. If not, he should get whatever he could become happy eating that. Ve'im en biyado liknot l'shalosh se'udot. If a person does not have financial stability, he doesn't have the means to buy for 3 meals of Shabbat, then what should he do? If he is not able, at least he should buy for two seudot. And he should not depend on himself getting money from people, you know, begging from others. No, even 2 seudot, 2 meals is good enough. And he should decrease he should decrease the needs of other weekdays. That he should have enough money to buy for the 2 seudot of Shabbat. If he doesn't have money even to obtain food for 2 seudot, 2 meals, then he should go and get money from the gabbai who gives sadaqa money, would lend him money or would give him sadaqa to go and buy food. Ve'ivakesh mazon lechol shalosh seudot. If he comes to that point, you should not go get food only enough for 1 seuda, 2 seuda. No. Once he goes to a gabbai sadaqa, he should obtain food for 2 seuda. So over here, let's go and explain further on this. Shaloti Yekavanata Adam, page 1. Nenhog. The Mefarshim is underlined. When hoget asmo ela yaseet onek bishvil kavod haShabbat. Now a person needs to understand, even though that is enjoyable to have good food on Shabbat, to dress the special suit for Shabbat, to go sleep, rest, everything, but one needs to be careful that you're not doing this because you want to enjoy yourself. No, you're doing this because you're doing the mitzvah of Shemirat Shabbat, that you're observing Shabbat for the sake of Hashem, that Hashem commanded us. Therefore, a person needs to eat and drink with a lot of happiness. Ma'achal to b'yafe mut'am u'metukan kal ha'ikhul. Now, you want to eat something that is good quality food and is easy to digest. Because, understand, if you have something that is hard to digest, then it's going to pressure you, it's going to pressure your digestive system, and it's going to make it hard for you, that Shabbat. So it says in the Torah, "Zachor et yom haShabbat leKadosho sheshet yamim ta'avod," that remember Shabbat and sanctify it. 6 days work. Ki sheshet yamim asah Hashem et haShemayim ve'et haRetz, that Hashem created the whole world, the universe, right, in 6 days, and Hashem made Shabbat the day of rest. Hashem did not do any more creation on Shabbat. שעניין שבת הוא שורש האמונה לדע שהעולם הוא מחודש. That one who keeps Shabbat, by keeping Shabbat, he is announcing that I agree with the creation. That Hashem created the whole world and I have Emunah to Hashem. וכיוון שברא הכל, since Hashem created the whole world, הוא אדון על הכל and he is the master over everything. ואנחנו עבדיו ומיוחבים לעשות לסונו ולעובדו בכל גופו ונשמתנו. That now we are his servants and we need to keep Shabbat with all our might, all our body and with all our money. כי הכל שלו, because everything is Hashem's. ויזירה התורה שמינת השבת שתיים אסתר פעמים. Very interesting point. Torah reminds us on the importance of Shabbat observance, that we should keep Shabbat 12 times. It is mentioned 12 times in the Torah. Ve'amru chachamim, and our sages of blessed memory teach us, kol ha'meshamer et ha'Shabbat ke'ilu mekayem kol ha'Torah. That whoever keeps Shabbat, it is as if he kept all the Torah, all the 613 mitzvot. This is not a joke, guys. Do you understand what that means? What that means is that all the mitzvot of the Torah can be, it's considered as if you kept all those mitzvot if you properly keep Shabbat. Even the mitzvot that you can not do it nowadays, because we don't have Beit HaMikdash. You are a Kohen, you are a Levi, we have a lot of mitzvot that have to deal with Beit HaMikdash, Korbanot, just can't do it. But you keep Shabbat, it is as if you even did those mitzvot. וכל המחלל שבת כאילו כפר בכל התורה כולה. And whoever desecrates Shabbat, whoever does not observe Shabbat, it is as if he is questioning the validity, the truth of the Torah. You know, in the Torah says 12 times, keep Shabbat. If you're not keeping Shabbat, in a way you're saying, I don't believe this Torah is divine, it's from Hashem. והכל מטעם הנזכר לאל. As we said, this all comes from Shoresh Emuna, that if you believe there is the Hashem, you keep Shabbat. וכן זה איתה גם כן במדרש רבה פרשת בשלח. This is also explained in מדרש רבה, פרשת בשלח. אמר רבי אלעזר בן אבינה, רבי אלעזר, the son of Avina says, Masinu be Torah ube Nevi'im ube Ketuvim, that we find in the Torah, Nevi'im, Ketuvim, Sheshagula Shabbat keneged kol ha-mitzvot. That keeping the Shabbat is equal to all the mitzvot. How do we know that? Shebesha'a she'a'a Moshe lo ma lahem, mitzvot Shabbat, amala HaKadosh Baruch Hu ben Hashem wanted to give the mitzvah of Shabbat to Moshe Rabbeinu. Hashem told him, עד אנא מנתם לשמור מצוותי ותורותי, מה כתיב אחריו? ראו כי השם נתן לכם השבת. ובנביאים מנאי שנאמר, וימררו בי בית ישראל במדבר, בחוקותי לא הלכו. מה כתיב אחריו? בית שבתי חיללו. So that from two places, we see that because Bnei Israel did not keep Shabbat, they were labeled as not observance. Right? That Hashem refers to Am Israel, the Jewish nation, as that they did not pursue my commandments, they did not keep my commandments. So therefore, it says right there, it says, because they did not keep Shabbat. They were mechallel Shabbat. So this comes with a reminder that all those wonderful Yehudim among Am Israel, that they do not keep Shabbat, most of them do not know the beauty of Shabbat, or they don't know how to keep Shabbat. They do not have proper education. And therefore one should not judge them negatively. One needs to reach out to them, tell them about the beauty of the Torah, about the beauty of Shabbat, and help them to become observance. Shomer Shabbat. As we say, Kiyesh Mera Shabbat, that one who keeps Shabbat, Yernish Meleni, Hashem keeps him. Hashem watches him over. Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu Israel. Hashem told to his nation, Am Israel, Im Tizku Lishmo Shabbat, מעלה אני עליכם כאילו שמעתם כל מצוות שבתורה. If you keep Shabbat, if you be zoche, if you merit to keep Shabbat, I would consider as if you kept all the mitzvot in the Torah. ואם חללתם אותו, and if you desecrate Shabbat, חס ושלום, לא עלינו. מעלה אני עליכם כאילו I would consider as if that you desecrated all the mitzvot of the Torah. And that is what the pasuk says, Shomer Shabbat mechallelo v'shomrei yado ma'asur kol ra'ah. And there is so much to talk about this, that how bad it is one who desecrates Shabbat. That's a big chilul Hashem, right? And it's not only a mitzvah, it's not only Isur Aseh, it's more than that. It's not only that he is desecrating a positive commandment. No, it's more than that. Avonot she'esh aleim isur lav, chamun mizeh, avonot she'esh aleim mita bidei shamayim. Shabbat, one who does not keep Shabbat, it is equivalent of bringing upon himself, lo aleinu, mita bedei shamayim, a heavenly death. Ve'o mitat chenech, the ma'ala mizeh is even greater than chenech. Choking. Otan she'onsham hu herek v'sayef is even greater than getting somebody killed by sword. Lema'ala mizeh, otan shemita b'serefa is greater than burning someone. Lema'ala mikolam otan shemitatan b'segila, it's even greater than segila. Ki hi achamura sheba mitot ve'al avon chilul shabbat b'mezid halo mitato hu. One who desecrates Shabbat knowingly, his punishment is segila. Stoning. Venochan liriot od. So if this goes on, one also needs to know that there are Ramach Mitzvot, 248 positive commandments, that these Mitzvot are corresponding to our limbs of the body. The same amount of limbs that we have is 248, like eyes, ears, mouth, heart, these limbs. are corresponding to one mitzvah. One who does not keep one mitzvah, he is considered like a blemished person.
And
that one who does not keep Shabbat, it is as if he is missing a limb. Or one of his limbs is not working properly.
Ken hu gam ken be inyene misfot Hashem mitbarach. This is also with the misfot Hashem. Shale gam ken kitiv ashe yaseh otam adam v'chay bahem. He says that these are the misfot that one needs to do, that one needs to keep them and to be alive with them.
As it says that the mitzvot of the Torah is your life, and this is compared to the days of your life. One who keeps mitzvot, he gives himself more life.
There are
a lot of mitzvot, pesukim that talks about this mitzvah of Shabbat.
Even a regular person, simple person, needs to keep Shabbat.
And one who doesn't keep Shabbat, he is considered like a blemished person. And in the world to come also, they consider him a blemished person. So let's move on. So from here, we learn a few important statements that our Chachamim emphasize on Shabbat, and that they give us insight into the importance of Shabbat. Number one, fulfillment of one's will. That one who keeps Shabbat, Hashem will fulfill his will. Number two, financial success and security. One who keeps Shabbat is worthy of attaining wealth in the merit of Shabbat observance. Hashem sends success and blessing to one's endeavors. That's based on Chafetz Chaim Parashat Ki Tisa. Number three, advocate on high. Shabbat is the powerful advocate on high for those who abide by its laws. That's Midrash Tanchuma and Bereshit. Number four, protects and forgives from sin. One who keeps Shabbat will be protected and distanced from sin. That's Mechilta. One who keeps the Shabbat can be forgiven for all his sins, even if he is guilty of adultery. But even if somebody worshipped false gods, but he keeps Shabbat, based on Talmud in Masechet Shabbat, Daf 118b, Hashem forgives him. Number five, acquires Yirat Shamayim. One who keeps Shabbat, he would acquire merit for Yirat Shamayim, fear of God. That's in Yevamot 93a. Number six, brings the redemption. If all the Yehudim were to observe two consecutive Shabbatim properly, then the redemption would immediately follow. So as we should said, Shabbat is the cornerstone of Emuna. One who refrains from workday affairs, he shows his emunah to Hashem. I know it's difficult not to work on Shabbat. I can understand that, because especially here in Los Angeles, downtown has more business on Shabbat. I don't know these days, but in the past at least. But one who believes that Hashem is giving him sustenance, if Hashem is giving him sustenance for 6 days of the week, he cannot give him sustenance for one more day of not going to work. Obviously Hashem could. So Shabbat is such a great day that the Gemara talks about it.
That Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu,
I have a squeezed gift in my treasure house. I have a very exceptional gift for you. And that is called Shabbat. And I want to give it to the Am Yisrael. That's what says in Gemara, Masechet Shabbat, Daf Yud Amud Bet. It is impossible to measure the value of this priceless gift, the enormous reward of cherishing it. So one needs to truly try to keep Shabbat and constantly learn the halachot. Be'ezrat Hashem, Hashem should help us that we keep Shabbat and we connect ourselves every day better and better to Hashem. Amen.